Hello friends and welcome back to Biosphere Flora. Today in this video we are going to talk about a Monstera variety which is actually known as a broken heart Monstera or Monstera adansoi. Now this plant is known as Monstera adansoi. This plant is also known as a broken heart Monstera because of the beautiful fenestrations and holes in them. Nowadays, this plant has been in a trend, whether it be the any variety of Monstera such as Monstera deliciosa, Monstera adansoi or Monstera obliqua. The fenestrations and the obligations and the pattern on them makes a very trendy and a popular plant as a home decor. They are also considered to be as an air purifying plant as a NASA's record. Now let us talk about some care tips and some maintenance, how you should provide them so that the plant remain in a healthy state and will become a bushier one. The first tip is the soil condition and the watering pattern. The water must be in such a way that the soil must be moist enough and the water retaining capacity must be there. So we use here the cocoa peat or the cocoa chips here. This will maintain the soil in a moisture state and will help the plant to grow in a better way. In the further video, we will also going to talk about and reveal some experience of mine which helped me to find out and figure out why the fenestrations are not be prominent and not appearing in the broken heart Monstera or any other variety of Monstera, even if the Monstera is in a mature state. Here I have used the soil component which I have shown in my Instagram feed. You can have them, link will be in my description box. Now the second and the most important component, which is the light. The light plays a very important role in the fenestration of these leaves and in a bigger size of the leaves. This plant is although a low light plant and in a moderate light plant, but not in a harsh or the too bright light condition plant, as because the prominent fenestrations only appear when the moderate light condition is provided to them. So I used to keep this plant in a place where it receives a bright light condition but not too a harsh and the direct sunlight ones, otherwise the tips might get burned and the whole plant decor will be damaged. Now you can clearly see the light has made this plant so beautiful looking plant. And now I will show you the previously the leaves which has been arising. I have shown a query on my Instagram account that why the fenestrations are not prominent in my Monstera. But I have wait and keep patience on them and provided them the regular care which I have provided in the Monstera. And now you can clearly see the new growth has a beautiful fenestrations and holes on them. So if sometimes you find that there is a no fenestrations on their leaves, then you should keep patience and wait for it. Even if you provided them a much better care and attention, then you will see the result which is happening is the fenestration will be occur in the new leaves which are growing. Another most important experience of mine why the fenestrations was not prominent is that while I was repotting, I have broken some of the roots, which was I think the main root. So the plant has gone in a shock, and that's why the reason was that the new leaves which is coming out has not any more fenestrations on them. But I keep patience and care them well, and now you can clearly see the fenestrations are prominent enough. The second care tip which helps the plant to grow in a bushier way and a healthy form is that the misting. You should always mist them so that this aerial roots come out. This aerial roots will help the plant to grow in a better way and capture the more amount of nutrition and the moisture from the environment. This node like plant such as the pothos, Monstera or any other varieties of pothos, silver pothos, satin pothos will help the plant to grow in a bushier and a long broad leaves will help the plant by misting them. Misting will help the plant to grow the aerial roots in a much quicker form as compared to the watering them on the soil. The next care tip is regarding the yellowing of tips and the browning of edges or sometimes burned leaf. This is mainly due to of three reasons behind it: the watering problem, lack of nutrition, and intense sunlight. Previously, I have talked about why the burning of the leaves happen because of the intense sunlight in this video. But the yellowing of the leaves is happen because of the majorly two reasons. First, the lack of nutrition, and the second is the watering problem. If you overwater this plant, then this plant will turn their edges yellow, or sometimes the whole leaf will turn yellow. But if you are assured that this plant is not having any underwatering or the overwatering problem, then you should provide them a proper amount of nutrition, fertilize them once a month so that they can have a healthy growth on them. So by analyzing them, the signs of the yellowing of the leaves, burning of the leaves, or any other problem, you can analyze them and benefit your plant by caring them in a much better way. Now, if your plant is start producing the aerial roots and the plant you think has become a laggy one, you should cut them from the tips so that they can have a bushier growth. Or if you want not to trail your plants longer, then you provide them a moss stick so that they can trail around the moss stick and have a bushier growth like as a pothos. That's all for today, guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you are new.